Since the traditional Italian motorbike manufacturer Benelli got its new owner and it was reborn, it started its new era with small cubic capacity motorbikes. But as the years are going on and on, the Benelli motorbikes are even more and more serious and the cubic capacities are going up and up. And the brand is making really serious things. For example, this backpack, which is absolutely waterproof. It has the Benelli logo on it and it's a very comfortable and good wearing, but we are not going to speak about it at all in this review. But the latest motorbike of them, the new 2020 model year bike, the 752 or 752S. The new Benelli is absolutely fitting to its class and it's important to speak about the class of it because it's the upper mid, let's say, naked bikes class because of the cubic capacity is close to 750 cubic centimeter. The name of the bike is also showing it, 752. This is not the exact number, but we are going to speak about it later. But the sizes of the bike are absolutely fitting to the class because the overall length is a little bit over 210 centimeters and the wheelbase is 1460 millimeters, so the dimensions are absolutely fitting to its class and also it's an absolutely let's say fresh and fashionable looking bike. Let's speak only a very few sentences about the design of the bike because it's really important in the case of a fashionable, modern, let's say, naked motorbike. The front lamp is a rounded one, but not absolutely circle-sized. Of course, the inside is LED technology, absolutely modern, and it's important that all the parts of the motorbikes are containing the brand identity. For example, in the lamp Benelli is also written. Let's check out the front mudguard. It's absolutely aerodynamic, aggressive and everything else. The very, very thick front telescopic forks. We are going to speak about them later. Now let's check only the design part of it. The huge, huge front disc brakes. The frame itself, which is fortunately colored to black, but the style of it you can see very, very clearly and it's very important that you can see this frame. The fuel tank is, let's say, aerodynamic but pretty aggressive anyhow, and of course the rear seat, the rider seat and the rear seat are also, let's say, this latest fashion style. This is not a positive thing that the passenger seat, the pillion seat, it's a very, very short one and the leg place of the pillion, the passenger is good for really nothing, really, really nothing. So it's not a comfortable place at all. Check out the exhaust pipe. It's looking like a racetrack exhaust pipe, but it's a Euro 4 exhaust pipe. I really do not understand how, according to the data of the motorbike, it's 91 decibel, the sound of it, but when you are sitting on the bike and pulling the throttle, you can hear that this is a racetrack exhaust pipe, so loud and so aggressive sound it has. And check out the rear mudguard. We have already seen at the 502C Benelli, pretty similar one with the indicators in it. So all in all, the whole bike, it's an absolutely fresh 21st century's aggressive naked bike style. Let's speak a few words about the engine. It's an inline two-cylinder and as I have already mentioned, the 725 is not really saying the cubic capacity because it's 754 and not 52 cubic centimeters and it's a 4-valve per cylinder DOHC inline two-cylinder engine. It's nearly sure, we do not know the technical data, but it's nearly sure that it's it has a 270 degree crankshaft, so all in all, because the sound of it is really beautiful and it has this thumping all the time when you are pulling the throttle. And the technical data of it are not really huge, the technical, so the power data, because the overall power output is 76 brake horsepower and the maximum torque is 67 newton meters, so it's not a too much pulled engine, but it's much better to check out how is it working in the real life on the street. Let's check out how this engine is working in the real life on the street. We because according to the numbers it's not too powerful, but when you start to pull the throttle, then the sound experience is also giving a lot of fun to the bike. Even over 100 kilometers per hour you can clearly hear the sound of the bike. And I just make a U-turn and let's check out the acceleration of it. Not a full throttle acceleration, just an everyday one, so how you are riding in the everyday life. The sound is simply beautiful. Even the throttle beep gearing down, you always do with the blips because of the sound experience. And now let's check out the suspension from the point of how is it working. In the front we have these two very sick upside down telescopic forks, and this small sign is saying pretty much Marzocchi, because the telescopic forks are coming from this Italian factory. The width is really unbelievable, 50 millimeters or 5 centimeters thick. This part really extremely thick and strong. The travel is 130 millimeters, and you can change on the two telescopic forks, the compression and the rebound damping, separately. And we will speak about it, how is it working on the road. And in the rear we have a central suspension unit. Funny, but Benelli is again giving us only the data of the travel of the suspension unit itself, which is 60 millimeters, which is saying for us nothing about the moving of the wheel, so we do not know that data really. We can change the preload of it with a tool, and you can also change the rebound damping of it with the tool as well, but it's much more important to check out how the suspension is working when we are riding. In the real life, this suspension is working absolutely great. The negative road mistakes are pretty comfortable with it, only the positives are hitting you a little bit. But for example, here in this curve, here we had some, and the behavior of the bike is not disturbed by these road bumps at all when you are in the curve, which is really a great thing. But for example, here will be a big one, check out this one. So these road bumps are already feelable when you are sitting. You can feel it on the handlebar and on your bottom as well. In the beginning of the review at the design section, we mentioned that we have very huge front brakes, which are really looking demonstratively, but the effectiveness are also very important, even more important than how they are looking like. They are really huge because the diameter of them is 320 millimeters, and they have Brembo radial 4-piston calipers, and which is really important that this is the maybe the first Benelli that I am riding, which has an absolutely sensitive, well-dosable brake, because the brake efficiency of the brand is usually good, but in the case of this 752S, the dosability and the necessary hand power is also extremely perfect. In the rear, we have one disc brake, the diameter is I think 260 millimeters, and it has only a 1-piston caliper, and which is a little bit strange for me, that the foot pedal of the rear brake is positioned here, the axle, and the brake pedal itself is coming backways, and it's a pretty strange position thing, because I have pretty huge feet, 48 size, European size, but for me it was not dosable at all, so it I could use the rear brake only on something like on and off, so or I had the maximum brake efficiency with the working ABS or had nothing, so it was pretty strange, but I think it's possible to fit it to your foot size and ankle mobility and things like this. A small problem that the steering angle is not too big, so when you have to make a U-turn, this is a pretty wide two-lane road, but even here the handlebar is turned absolutely to the maximum, so if you have to turn around on a narrower road, then it really can cause problems to you. The seat position is absolutely fitting to the, let's say, sporty and classical naked bike style. The foot pegs are positioned pretty high, and the leg, let's say the knee angle, is pretty sharp, so it's the down part is a sporty one, but not uncomfortable at all, even for me, although I have very, very long legs. The only problem I had is the seat itself, because it's not uncomfortable, but a little bit too hard maybe. I have already ridden today with the bike some 220-240 kilometers, and honestly, I am really accustomed to like ride much longer distances than this, but anyhow, my bottom is aching a little bit, so the seat itself could be a little bit softer. The upper body's position is absolutely perfect, relatively sitting only a little bit bent to the front, so you can really bend on the wind very, very well. The handlebar is wide enough, the upper body position is really, really comfortable. Even the mirrors are not disturbing you with the wind noise, because this is maybe the biggest advantage of the 752S, that this is a real naked bike. You only have this very, very small dashboard and a very, very small let's say wind protector, or I don't know what aerodynamic piece of plastic on the top of it. So anyhow, you really get the pure wind to your helmet. And I was riding the bike with my 5 or 6 year old opened Nolan helmet, and now it became clear again that even this helmet, it is not noisy at all, even at 180 kilometers per hour, because there is no wind protection which is making turbulence. And if you have no turbulence, then you are not really having wind noise. Let's check out the dashboard. It's a very, very simple one, absolutely informative, because we can see all the necessary data on it, but nothing too much. For example, the board computer here in the down, it's not really nice to call it as a board computer, because it has only these data that you can see. You have one button on the right handlebar, and you can change only one thing to make it miles or kilometers, and make the only one trip meter of yours to zero, and fix the exact time. And but it's what is really important, that not as in the case of the Benelli 502C, even when it is a very, very strong sunshine, you can see it, not absolutely clearly, but you can see it, and it has a night picture as well. The guys, maybe the marketing guys at Benelli are loving it very much, that when it becomes dark, then the picture of the dashboard is also changing, and it becomes black one, with a totally different picture and graphics and design and everything, which was really funny for me, that when it was a really strong sunshine and I changed the dashboard to this one, with covering this small part in the left bottom side of the dashboard panel, so this picture is much better seeable at extremely strong sunshine than this this one, which is called the daily dashboard. So all in all, with the brand new 752S, Benelli made a really great motorbike, because the power is absolutely enough for the streets. It's not a powerhouse, but anyhow, the power of it is absolutely enough for the everyday riding. The sound is extremely nice. The suspension and the brakes are absolutely over its class. So it's really a great motorbike, and especially if you check out the price of it, because that's absolutely reliable. So if you are looking to the, let's say, upper mid-size naked bikes, then you have to check it for sure. And if you like the motorbike, then push a thumb up. Or if you like the review, push a thumb up as well. If you haven't done it yet, please subscribe for our channel and watch our previous contents as well. And under the review, you can find the link where you can donate. Thanks a lot for your kind attention.